Yeah.
What's going on, New Gaming Order? We are back like the Juggernaut, bitch, and we're hitting a more tech topic. You know, so it's not directly gaming related, but it does because Windows 10 is going to definitely affect how games are enjoyed between the Xbox One, Windows 10 PC devices, and what have you. But just wanted to touch on a couple of things. And, you know, for those of you who want to follow along, let me put the link in the chat. If you guys are actually in the chat discussing things, we can all just take a feature and just, you know, talk about it. But main thing I wanted to touch on, okay, those of us, like myself and Shinwa, we already have the Windows 10 beta, and I've been messing around with it. It's really good. It's really, really good. I think that the whole thing with Windows 8 and 8.1, you know, I have 8.1 on the streaming computer that NYC Playboy that helped provide for the stream, and I got used to it. I don't think that it was as bad as everybody made it out to be. I think it's just like the arrangement of the GUI. But when you look at Windows 10 and how it took Windows 8 and Windows 7 and kind of mashed it up, they did a very good job at doing that. And I think that with this, it's going to be well received, especially with the fact that we got the, for 1 year, those of us with legit Windows, you bad boys know who you are, who don't.
No, everyone gets the upgrade, Alex, even booty copies.
No. They, yeah. Matter of fact, they actually said they will get like an update, but they won't get like they'll get the upgrade, but no updates, no security updates. It'll run unstable, that's all like kinds of shit.
That won't stop certain people, Alex. You know.
A matter of fact, Phil Spencer even put that out there. Man, I should have used that as a topic. But yeah, they're actually now retracting a lot of what they said with the pirated copies going over. But with that, you know, there's some July 29th, they're going to start rolling a lot of this stuff out for the Xbox One and what have you. But I do know, matter of fact, I wanted to make sure, and I apologize, bear with me. Did you guys get the link to the topic in the chat?
Yeah, it's there.
Okay, and then I just wanted to talk about
it's just broken slightly, but they can just like easily just, you know, copy and paste it.
Ah, okay. No problem.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
I don't know why I did that, but
it's fine.
Now, there are some features with Windows 10 that you're going to lose, but they're supposedly replacing them. You know, PCMag.com provided this topic that, you know, and I just wanted to share that with you guys. Now, the first one, Media Center is going away. Put a grenade in it, boom. You know, so I'm going to just dissect little by little. And, you know, now that Media Center is going away, what are your thoughts? So let me start on your knees. Now that that's getting ripped away, is that a good or a bad thing for the operating system?
Well, I just confirmed what you told me, and I'm very sad about that. So I'll have to think of a new solution for people I know. I'll put it that way.
I told you. I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I wasn't really paying attention. I assumed certain people would be getting a free upgrade. Leave it at that.
Everybody's getting an upgrade.
You can get your upgrade, but you'll still be a non-legitimate upgrade. You'll still be non-genuine, as they like to put it.
Well, I heard that doesn't mean nothing, to be honest with you. I heard that you'll get the upgrade regardless, but they'll separate it to the point. Let's say if you have like a Windows 7 Home or Windows 8 Home, you will only get the Home Edition. If you have any Pro versions, such as Windows 7 Pro or Windows 8.1 Pro, you get the Pro version, despite whatever. Because the thing is, as long as it reads the software ID license within your Windows product key, it will just still legitimize it when it gets the 3 to 4 gigabyte update.
It's going to run unstable, though. Is security issues are going
to... I'm pretty sure it's just going to work, and they're going to just say, you know what, fuck it, we're pushing this out to a million other people in their homes, and we want them to get our shit. And if they don't get it within that time frame, they'll have to either pay $200 or freaking $200 or... I think it was like 170 something for the home version.
I just don't see Microsoft just giving away an OS. It's not going to happen.
No, they were going to do it because they got to compete with China. That's the only reason why they're doing this.
Mm-hmm. Who are Microsoft now? Enron? Something like that? Are they from China?
All right. But before we go all over the place, I just wanted to, you know...
Get back Windows, on topic.
Windows Media Center going away. Good or a bad thing, Chris?
Well, I'm more concerned about losing my Minesweeper, actually, and my floppy drive support.
I
want to play my 5 1/4-inch games, which I lost many years ago, but I want to have the ability to ham it, damn it.
Mm-hmm. But I'm also hearing, like, and, you know, I'm just going to change it where, you know, anybody can jump in on it. DVD playback. You know, I'm like, a little worried, you know, because...
Most computers don't even have DVD players anymore, so it's not a problem. Hell, when I did some work on my computer, I didn't even install the... when I swapped out my video card, I had to unplug some stuff. I didn't even plug my DVD ROM back in. I don't have a DVD ROM in my computer anymore.
Unbelievable.
It's all digital distribution. And if I need the DVD player, just hook it back up for whenever, however long I need it.
Okay. Well, I mean, I think that's number two on the list. But then desktop gadgets, those are going away. You know,
I never used them. I don't know many people that did.
Maybe they just figured out, hey, screw it, it's time to get rid of it.
It was underutilized, because they could track that kind of usage in your operating system.
Yeah.
So it was just something underutilized, and they're not going to support it.
Yeah, that is basically cutting the bullshit, like what you said with the home, the Windows Media thing. Really, when external hard drives came out, that shit stopped. Period. Yeah. And now you can streamline anything regardless. You don't need to have Windows Media Center anymore. You can streamline it off of, like, literally almost any program now.
Yeah.
It's done. It was a good implementation back then when we didn't have the technology. But now, since that we're in the point where everything is streamlined, it's done.
Well, you know, there's possible Kodi, Plex, and Media Portal. Those might be replacements according to PCMag.com. But, you know, that remains to be seen. But anybody else want to add to that before I go to the next feature that may be lost? Yes, no, maybe so. Okay.
No.
Moving on. Solitaire, Minesweep.
And no!
Why?
Well, again... again, it doesn't matter because you could just go online and play them free on the internet. Done.
There you go.
Done.
Damn, Nelson. Why you got to step on the ladybug?
All right, so look. If you want Windows 98, Alex, then stay on it. Stay on Windows 98.
That probably don't even work.
He's on Windows 1. Who the fuck are you kidding?
God damn.
Oh, the one that ran on the disc?
No, he's like that guy. There was a video someone put out a year or two ago. He set up Windows, I think it was Windows 7 at the time because Windows 8 wasn't out. He set up a virtual machine on 7 for Vista. Then on that Vista, set up a virtual machine for XP. And he worked all the way back to Windows 1. And then he set up a virtual machine in Windows 1 for DOS.
Oh my god.
So he had like
this
freaking inversion or inception, like 10 virtual machines, each one playing the previous Windows.
That's crazy. That's awesome though. You know what? We gotta put a link to that. That's pretty damn sick. Alright, well, next feature, floppy disk support on your knees that jump the gun. You know. Good riddance. That old technology, don't need it anymore. You got little micro SDs that hold more.
If you have a need for it, you'll know how to get it to work. That's what it boils down to.
Yeah, but I mean,
There are still some businesses out there that run on these ancient machines that still use 5 1/4. You know, I kind of twinge when I say that. Hell, this picture even has what the 8 1/3-quarter disc size.
Yeah,
the freaking massive. But there are still some businesses out there with legacy machines that are running these ancient programs, with computers with no hard drives, just because they have custom hardware that won't work with any other computers.
Yep.
So there may still be a need for it. You know, it's like, okay, we finally got new machines. We want to we need to get our, you know, whatever. We have these blueprints. We need to put these from these floppies into the new system.
Yeah. Archiving.
In a rare case like that, you spend the $20, you order your 3 1/4, 5 1/2, whatever, off eBay.
Yeah.
Get shit done. But yeah, that's just one of those where it's not even a problem.
Okay. I mean, libraries can still keep that as like an archiving method or something, but, you know. All right, moving on to the next. Windows Essentials, OneDrive application. I never used it. I don't know.
Who the fuck used it? I never did.
Good luck. Let me see you.
I never used it either.
I don't put my shit on the cloud. It's on the cloud. The government has
now.
It's going to be an Inbox One version. It's like an Inbox version of OneDrive. I think I kind of have like that set up on my Windows 10 already, but. But yeah, Nelson, you were saying?
I think it's going to be associated with your Outlook now.
Ah.
Yeah, I think they're just trying to compress it because it is a Microsoft product, and you know, Outlook, it usually combines everything and all the essentials into one. It's just that, from what I'm hearing, dude, all the shit that you're mentioning is basically on the hard disk, like on machine, but all those features you can still use when you open your web browser and get this shit. That's it. That's what I'm hearing right now. It's really not destroying anything.
No. It's just pointing this stuff out. But with that, I mean, those are the features that supposedly, I don't think they're significant. The only thing, I don't know. I think that Microsoft is doing a smart thing. Needless stuff, get rid of it. Because like you said, Nelson, a lot of that stuff they could just play online or whatnot in terms of the solitaire and what have you. But as far as like, you know, the floppy disk support, we don't, the machines, it's just archaic. It's old, you know. But with that, I don't think it lost much. You know what I mean? I don't even know why it was even given an article from PCMag.com, but it's just something I felt we needed to cover. But with that, does anybody have anything else to add to that before we close up the segment?
Nah.
Alrighty.
I'm just going to hold off for a year, maybe two, because, you know, stuff will crop up. So,
yeah.
Especially with OS, I'm not a first day one adopter when it comes to operating systems, especially when it comes to anything from Microsoft.
And
yeah,
you know what?
The first service pack always.
Yeah, Vista. I skipped Vista. I skipped Millennium or the ME. I skipped a couple of Windows.
Yeah,
you
skipped the
even number. I played with Vista for a while, and I got rid of it.
You skipped the even number operating system.
You're breaking up, Tacoma.
No, that was me.
Ah.
I'm still. Yeah,
oh, okay. No.
There you go.
Oh, I was just saying, you got to skip the even number operating systems with Windows. They're garbage.
Well, Microsoft's plan is to make this Windows stick around for a while. Like, they're trying to not have
They
to...
said the same thing with 8.
See how long that lasted.
They did. Well, wait, hey, it remains to be seen. You know, and then now with Windows 10 coming to the Xbox One, where you can stream the Xbox One games onto the PC. That should be very, 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 very interesting. But with that, we're going to bring this topic to a close. Make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. Shout out to Fullscreen, our partner, newgamingorder.com. And we'll see you on the next segment. Peace.